Okay, welcome back. In the last video, we've learned how we can set our stairs if we want to move on them and how to set the direction with the shadow pen. Now, let's create some bridges. And for that, we will use events. And in this video, we will also learn about two new functions. Let's begin with the pause function. First, let's create a bridge tile. Let's take this guy, or this guy for example. And we will write this function inside this node tag window here. And this then the position function needs two values, the x and y values to position the tile on the map. So let's try this out for now. Let's, for example, move the tile into that direction. So you start with plus 0, because we don't want to move it on the x-axis, and plus 1. We want to move it for one tile into the on the y direction. So let's start the game if this works to see. And it does, as you can see. It was placed here, and now it's moved by one tile, exactly one tile into that direction. So where is this useful? We could use it maybe for Windows. If you remember our last tutorial on the Windows tutorial, let's copy this window and let's place it here somewhere for now. And let's create real quick a house. Maybe we will place it here. And on top put a roof like that. And now let's place the window here. And let's copy another window here. And also let's increase the height of this house, like this for example. So it's a little bit taller. Now we want the window to show, to be placed on the same position like the event, but we cannot place events over events. So this is where this function comes handy. If you want to do that, just open up the window event and add the pause function like that. And we don't want to move it on the X position, so we want to move it just on the Y position, and we want to move it in this direction, so we have to add a negative value of 1 in the Y position. And this is how the function should look like. Hit OK. And now when we start the game, this tile will be moved on the same position like this event is, but we won't see it because it will be on the same position also in the Z axis. So let's increase the Z value by amount of 1.2. Let's start. And then let's see how this works. As you can see, the windows are now aligned on top of each other, thanks to the position function. And here this is weird, because I placed the wrong tile on that position. I have to place the west pointing one, so it looks fine. And you can now, if you like, copy paste this window here, this one here, this one here and here. And when you start the game like this, you will have tons of windows aligned on the building. Of course, maybe you want to align it a little bit better than I do, but this is just to demonstrate how this might work. Let's close this now. Delete all these windows, we don't need them anymore. Also, let's delete this house. So now, we want to use this bridge to be connected with the other heights or hills. To do that, we have to place them so that the bridge is aligned in our case to the same height, because we want to walk on top of the bridge after we leave this height. But for this we will need and learn about a new function that's called elevation. And what elevation does, you guessed it maybe, it will elevate the event to a certain height. So you write it down like this, and since this height is on 4, we write down a height of 4. And also let's maybe use this bridge, because it's pointing this way. And when we copy paste this a couple of times like that, we can make a connection to this height here. Let's start the game and let's see how this looks like. Oh yeah, and of course when you write a function you should probably write it correctly. Elevation like that. Yeah, and now we just change it for this single one. Let's delete all the other bridges like that, real quick, just to demonstrate that this could be a really cool way to connect hills with bridges like that. And now we have a bridge connecting to this other stairs. Let's close this for now. And let's remove just this height here, we don't need them. Now let's use our 3D models for that. And let's create some different stairs. Let's use these ones. And let's place it maybe somewhere here. Like that. Let's place a lot of them like this. And let's make them all face to the south. Oh, that was wrong. Like this. Okay, now let's don't forget to set the height properly. So we begin with 1 here, and then the height is increasing up to 7, I think. Yeah, it will be a height of 7 then. Like that. So let's try to make a connection to this higher point. So how can we do that? For this purpose, let's use a model for our bridges. And just write in the model function like that. And the model that we will use for this purpose is called bridgestone01.obj. And also we need a different elevation, and I think it was a 4 on this side, yeah, elevation of 4 to walk on this platform. No, it actually, that's the wrong name. That's the name for a different model that I wasn't importing inside here. Platform Stone 01 is the name of the model. Let's check real quick. Yeah, that's the platform that I've created. Good. And we can already walk on top of this model without any problems. Now let's create our custom stairs height and walk on them. So we can also make stairs with our models or our events in this case, and make them so that we can move higher or to lower parts of our environment. So let's do that. Let's first try to make a connection to this stairs here. Just copy and paste it like that. And from here on, what we want to do is just to change the elevation to 5 and then copy this guy up to this point. And then we could move on this guy. And then let's create some more of these stairs like this. Let's make this one to have an elevation of 6 maybe. And this one to have elevation of 7. And then copy this and connect to this height here. And then start the game and see if this works. And it will probably not, and I will show you why. Of course, we set a higher elevation, but now we cannot move on top of this. So, and this is because of our stair threshold that is set to a really low value. Let's close this. Since this has an elevation of 5, also I think the elevation of 5 is a little bit too high. Let's make it a little bit lower, like 4.5 for example, for this guy, and 5 for this guy. And for this guy, let's leave it like that. Same thing here. Let's transition to a lower value first. 5.5 for this guy, and this guy should be fine. So the actual distance now is 0.5. If we want to pass to the higher value, we have to increase our stair threshold, and this is something that we can do in our plugin settings. Now scroll down to the setting that's called stair threshold and increase it to 0.5, and now we should be able, let's place him here for now, to walk on top of our 3D objects. Like that. Yeah, and I forgot to change the elevation height of this guy. It's still too high. So what's that? 7. Let's make it 6. And this guy, make it 6.5 maybe. And now we should be able to walk to the highest height of this map here without any problems. Yeah, and of course, let's just real quick change the direction of this guy's, because I said I want to face it to the south, but actually it's better to face them to the north so we can move down. Let's do this real quick. So this is facing to the north. Like that, because what I want to also be able to move down from the other side. And now we should be able to do that. Just like this. And you can always, if you want to maybe change the platform for specific parts, the second model is just called the same name with a different value, with a different number value. It's called Platform Stone 2. You can change it for these guys maybe here to have a different platform. You can always do it in the event settings if you like, real quick. And then maybe you want to use them for a specific, I don't know, for specific bridges maybe. Let's make a connection all over to the other bridge here, to the other stairs, like that. Now let's check first the height. So actually we don't need these ones. And Yeah, these ones has the same height. So these guys are different now, and we can move like that. We can also, if you want, move below like this, and this can create a really interesting effect with all these shadows. And yeah, that's just something that you couldn't do before in the standard RPG Maker MV. And maybe you want to make it a little bit more, I don't know, realistic or something. You just place a height of 4 here, 1 here maybe, 1 here, 1 here. So it looks like the bridge is on top of some grounds or something like that. Yeah. And of course, these bridges are now elevating in the air, because the elevation starts from that point where the height ends from the ground below. So as you saw, just delete these events here and it will not have any floating bridges anymore. So this is how you create bridges for your project and how you can connect them. Also how you can create your own stairs. You can create either these ones or these ones, and always take care for the stair threshold, because these settings decides if you can even move on a stair or not. So in the next video, we will expand our custom tile set and create a village.